Hello and a very warm welcome to my Elance profile. I'm Vikram Malik and first and foremost, I would like to thank you for checking out my Elance profile, especially if you're a client, a prospective client who would possibly, you know, look to hire me for your project. Even otherwise, I would definitely like to thank you for passing by and actually taking a look at my profile video. In case you're watching this on Elance, you will probably note that it's a relatively smallish screen which appears there in front of you. You can always click the title of the video or towards the bottom and then the video will open up on YouTube where you can see it in full. And there I've actually posted links below the video which will definitely help you. What I've done is that across different project categories and project types, I've showcased the kind of work that I've done and the kind of feedback which I've received. I think it'll really help you making up your mind, especially if you're a prospective client watching this video, in making up your mind as far as, you know, hiring me for your project is concerned. Now, before I get into all of that, some of you might question the wisdom of my actually setting up an Elance profile video now when we all know that Elance is closing down soon. I just look at it this way, that before closing down, I want to make the most of the time which is available. All these years, I've had an amazing time, more than 50,000 plus. I think right now I'm at about 57,000 odd dollars in earnings and 400 plus projects completed. So, you know, I would definitely like to end up at a roundish figure, whatever that is. 400 if I can make it, 500 projects, nothing like it, 57, I don't know, 60, 65, 70, I don't know. I don't want to, you know, fixate myself on a particular figure, but rather just make the most of the time which is available. I think that's how I would put it. Now, as far as my services are concerned, first of all, you know, if you look at my tagline, I've kept it very simple: high quality writing, translation and transcription. As far as the first bit, which is writing, is concerned, I offer a wide array of services. It could be article writing, it could be ebook writing, it could be just about any form of content creation in the English language. Now, regarding the English language, a lot of you, at least those in Western countries, have this ridiculous notion that when it comes to people in India, they don't speak English or they are not very well conversant in English. Somehow they are linguistically challenged when it comes to the English language. That is absolutely not true. And I think more than anything else, you should look at me the way I speak. That should be, you know, more than adequate proof. And yes, while there are some people who can probably speak well and not write well, I don't think I come under that category. I can write perhaps even better than I can speak. So therefore, as far as quality of my writing is concerned, you can be absolutely rest assured. And therefore, I reiterate my, you know, ability to create a variety of different content. What I've done, as I mentioned in the beginning, specific to writing assignments, I have showcased projects with, you know, I've showcased the project link as well, where you can click on that and you'll actually be able to see not just the project itself, but also the feedback which I received from the client on that particular project. Say within article writing, there are articles I've written for internet marketing. There are articles I've written for, say, online casinos. There are articles I've written for, say, candle making, for dog breeding, blah, 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 blah. You know, different categories of, say, topics or niches in which I've created content. So those, the kind of feedback which I've received, I think should give you a good pointer towards my ability to deliver. Hair loss, you know, that's something which I probably don't need. Maybe the moderators on Elance's the water cooler section, they probably need that. But nonetheless, I've created content in that niche as well. So you can take a look at that too. And after that, apart from, say, writing, I do a lot of translation work. Now, specific to translation, my own language per se is Hindi, you know. I avoid using the word native because it's abused on these freelance sites a lot, because somehow they assume, people out there assume that when it comes to nativity, somehow it has something to do with where you belong. I don't look at it that way. I can be native to the English language without being an American or Australian or New Zealander or Britisher or Canadian. It has nothing to do with where one belongs. Like, proficiency in languages comes to anybody anywhere. To give you an example, You can check out an actor called Tom Alter. He's an American. You should listen to him the way he speaks Hindi or Urdu. I think he can beat us, so-called native, where we are born and brought up in India, any day. His diction, his vocabulary in Hindi or Urdu is outstanding, absolutely outstanding. And there are so many such examples. And English in India is very much like a native language, where we from childhood, I've actually studied English formally, I've studied Shakespearean plays. My entire education was completely in English, and so is that of millions in the country. So therefore, and in fact, the world's largest circulated English language daily is an Indian one, The Times of India. Again, you can do your Google research and you can check that out. So that's something. As far as translation is concerned, I do Hindi, English, English, Hindi translation. And I also do English, Bengali, Bengali, English translation. Bengali is my mother tongue, so to speak, because my mother is a Bengali. So that's something which I can deliver on. Having said that, I've done a lot of other translation assignments on Elance, on and off Elance both, particularly Polish and Scandinavian languages like Swedish, Norwegian, Finnish, Danish. I've done a lot of German and French translation as well. I myself don't quite know these languages as such, but that's something which I very, very clearly and categorically clarify to the project owners that, hey, this is not something which I'll be doing, but I have so and so who will do the translation for you, and this is what you are paying me in totality. As long as the amount that they were paying to me was okay with them, I think it's none of anybody else's business what I am paying to the freelancers or the freelance translators and what I'm keeping for myself. Project coordination has its own set of challenges which demand a certain level of compensation. So, which is something which a lot of agencies, translation agencies on Elance, you'll see a lot of translation agencies from Pakistan who do a lot of this kind of work. Obviously, they're not experts in all the languages, but still they're doing it, and I'm sure clients are aware of that. So that's something. Now, as far as the third kind of service that I offer is concerned, that is transcription. Transcription where I listen to audio and then present it in the textual form, typically in MS Word. So I'm listening to the audio and then I'm typing things out. Now, in the transcription niche, I definitely expect a certain suitable level of compensation, which is practically non-existent on these freelance sites, which is at least $1 an audio minute. So an hour of audio should ideally compensate $60. Unfortunately, we don't get that kind of compensation, for which I would blame freelancers more than anybody else, because they have lowered the bar for themselves. If you are smart enough and you maintain a certain price where everybody maintains that price, then obviously no clients will not expect lower prices. Now, between say a Mercedes and an Audi and a BMW, they've all kept certain premium prices. Just because somebody else, one of them starts lowering their prices dramatically, the others don't follow suit. There's a certain level of, there's a tag of premium attached to them, which is something to be retained. Unfortunately, we freelancers, what we've done is we've gone on, competing against price, competing on price, competing on price, where the bar keeps getting lower and lower and lower. So that's something unfortunate, but that's how it is. What can be done? So these are the three services which I offer. Again, I would reiterate that please explore the open up the video on YouTube in case you're watching on my Elance profile. There you can see a lot of links to projects. I've posted links across these project categories and wherever possible within categories like writing, I've put in sub projects like writing within a particular niche, writing within a particular sub niche, etc., etc. And you can see the kind of feedback which I've received. And as I mentioned, the aim of this video is to showcase my skills and maximize the time which is left as far as Elance is concerned. So these are the things which I wanted to cover in this video. Last thing which I want to mention is that, this is one of the many things which I do. I do a lot of other content creation for myself, not really directly related to the freelancing space, but within the freelancing space itself, also I create content on my own. So feel free to the YouTube channel on which I'm actually posting this video. I've posted other videos as well related to freelancing. So you can feel free to explore them as well. That they will also give an idea. Like right now you see so much of panic surrounding the whole, you know, Elance closure. Oh my God, what's going to happen? I don't look at it that way. You know, life goes on. And anyway, life is full of unpredictability. So you have to be prepared for unforeseen circumstances. If you're an individual who's, you know, who's so dramatically affected by the closure of a particular platform, then it's you who's probably compromised his or her state of existence. So on that note, I'll, you know, move towards concluding my video. I would like to again say, convey a big thanks to you for watching my video. And if you're a client, please feel free to hire me. I think through this video, I've showcased my skills extensively. Beyond that, please feel free to contact me through Elance. Cheers.